Hello students, we know the Laplace transform of derivative of a function, Laplace transform of integral. Now today we see the Laplace transform of multiplication by powers of t. So theorem, let f, Laplace transform of f of t is equal to f of s, then Laplace transform of t raised to n into f of t is equal to minus 1 raised to n into nth derivative of f of s with respect to s, d raised to n by ds raised to n of f of s, where f of s is the Laplace transform of f of t. We prove this theorem by mathematical induction. First, we prove the result is true for n is equal to 1, then n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, and we suppose that the result is true for n is equal to r, and we prove that the result is true for n is equal to r plus 1 also, and so on. What is given? Let Laplace transform of f of t is equal to f of s. This is given. Now you know the f of s means integration going from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into f of t dt. So this is given. And nth derivative of f of s, f raised to n, s means this is the nth derivative of f of s with respect to s. Now first we prove that the result is true for n is equal to 1. Now what is f of s? F of s is equal to integration going from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into f of t dt by definition of Laplace transform. Differentiating with respect to s on both sides. Therefore, differentiating with respect to s on both sides, what do we get? Derivative of f of s is equal to derivative of this integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into f of t dt. So first derivative of f of s means, this means f raised to dash f of s, f dash of f of s f dash of f of s is equal to, this can be written as integration going from 0 to infinity, partial derivative, here e raised to minus st f of t is another function and integration is with respect to t, partial derivative of e raised to minus st into f of t dt. Therefore, derivative of e raised to minus s2 with respect to s means integration going from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into derivative of minus st with respect to s means minus t into f of t dt. Therefore, this can be written as, you take minus outside the integration and minus 1 into f dash s is equal to integration going from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into t into f of t dt. And what is this? Right hand side is the Laplace transform of t into f of t. So is equal to Laplace transform of t into f of t, and left side is minus 1 raised to 1 into f dash s Now you have to prove the result by mathematical induction. Laplace transform of t raise to n into f of t is equal to minus 1 raise to n, nth derivative of f of s. This. Here if n is equal to 1, Laplace transform of t raise to 1 into f of t is equal to minus 1 raise to 1 into f dash of f of s. Thus, the result is true for n is equal to 1. Similarly, we prove the result is true for n is equal to 2. Similarly, we have same method, Laplace transform of or minus 1 raise to 2 into f double dash of s, second derivative of f of s is equal to Laplace transform of t square into f of t, and Laplace transform of t cube f of t is equal to minus 1 cube into f triple dash s, and so on. We suppose that the result is true for n is equal to r. N is equal to r, and you prove that the result is true for n is equal to r plus 1. N is equal to r means minus 1 raise to r into r derivative of f of s is equal to Laplace transform of t raise to r into f of t. And your aim is to prove the result is true for n is equal to r plus 1. Laplace transform of t raise to r into f of t means integration going from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st into t raised to r into f of t dt, minus 1 raised to r into f r derivative of f of s. Again, you differentiate this with respect to s. Differentiating with respect to s, we get what we get? Minus 1 raise to r as it is into f raise to r means derivative of f of s with respect to s. So again, differentiating this means derivative of f of s, r plus 1th derivative of f of s with respect to s is equal to integration going from 0 to infinity derivative of e raised to minus st into t raised to r into f of t dt. So is equal to again, integration derivative of e raised to minus st is e raised to minus st into derivative of minus st with respect to s, not r. With respect to s means minus t into t raised to r into f of t dt. Again, here minus 1. So, you take left side, therefore this become minus 1 raise to r plus 1 into r plus 1th derivative of f of s with respect to s is equal to here e raise to minus s t and t into t raise to r. T into t raise to r means t raise to r plus 1. And e raised to minus st, minus 1 is left side you have taken. Therefore, this is the Laplace transform of t raised to r plus 1 into f of t. And here, r derivative of f of s means f this means f raised to r plus 1 f of s. So what is this? Minus 1 raised to r plus 1 into f raised to r plus 1. Means r plus 1 the derivative of f of s. Thus, the theorem is true for r is equal to 1 plus 1. Similarly, it is true for n is equal to r plus 2, n is equal to r plus 3, and so on. Now, using this theorem, we see some examples. Now, you find the Laplace transform of t into sine 3t and Laplace transform of t square into sine 3t. Now, our theorem is Laplace transform of t raised to n into f of t is minus 1 raised to n into nth derivative of f of s. Already you know that Laplace transform of sine 3t is 3 upon s square plus 3 square. S 3 square is 9. 3 upon s square plus 9. And here you have to find the Laplace transform of t into sine t. You put n is equal to 1. Therefore, Laplace transform of t into sine 3t is equal to minus 1 raised to 1 into first derivative of f of s. So your f of s is 3 upon s square plus 9. You take its first derivative. Minus 1 raised to n. And you know the derivative of 1 upon x minus 1 upon x square. Here, minus 1 raised to 1 minus plus. That is 3 upon s square plus 9 square into derivative of s square plus 9 with respect to s means 2s plus 0. Therefore, is equal to 6s upon s square plus 9 square. So, this is the Laplace transform of t into sine 3t. Now, next example, Laplace transform of t square into sine 3t is equal to, again using this rule, minus 1 square into second derivative of f of s. F of s means this, 3 upon s square plus 9. Already you have find its first derivative or using this. So, this can be written as minus 1 raised to 1 into first derivative of this, second, 6s upon s square plus 9 square. Therefore, minus 1, so by using u upon v rule, quotient rule, so you get s square plus 9 square as it is into derivative of s, 1, 6 common, minus s as it is into derivative of s square plus 9, that is s square plus 9 square is derivative is 2 into s square plus 9 into derivative of s square means 2s upon s square plus 9 square and its square means s square plus 9 raised to 4. After simplifying this, you get 18 into s square minus 3 upon s square plus 3 cube. So, this is the Laplace transform of t raised to 2 into sine 3t. Thank you, students.